Here we have the integral of sine squared of theta times cosine squared of theta d theta. And we've already seen that when you have even powers, it's sometimes hard to use substitution. Because, for example, if we used u equals sine of theta, then we'd have du over cosine theta equals d theta. So we'd have the integral of u squared cosine squared theta du over cosine theta, and only one of these cosines would cancel out, and then we don't have any good identity or formula to substitute in, and same thing if we tried u equals cosine of theta. So that tells me that we have to try something else. So we either need to get this maybe in terms of all cosines or all sines, or something else. So we have some options. Looking at our identities. So we could get things in terms of all sine or all cosine using that Pythagorean identity, but then we're still going to have things squared, which may or may not work out. We also have these two power reducing formulas. Now if we look at these, this says that we can plug something in for sine squared of x and get something in terms of cosine of 2x. And we can plug something in for cosine squared of x and get something in terms of cosine of 2x. So these two things, if we make these substitutions, will get us everything with cosines of 2x's. Or in this case, we have thetas, so in cosines of theta, 2 thetas. So let's see what happens. So if we say, all right, sine squared of x, or sine squared of theta, equals 1 minus cosine of 2 theta divided by 2, and cosine squared of theta is 1 plus cosine of 2 theta divided by 2 d theta. Then, first thing that we can do is we can multiply the denominators and pull out a fourth. So we get 1/4 times the integral of 1 minus cosine of 2 theta times 1 plus cosine of 2 theta d theta. Now we can FOIL these to get 1/4 times the integral, 1 minus cosine of 2 theta plus cosine of 2 theta minus cosine squared of 2 theta d theta. So we have a negative cosine of 2 theta and a positive cosine of 2 theta, so those cancel. So we have 1/4 times the integral of 1 minus cosine squared of 2 theta d theta. Okay, so we can split apart these integrals to get 1/4 times the integral of d theta minus the integral of cosine squared of 2 theta d theta. So we know that the integral of d theta is theta. So what we need to find is the integral of cosine squared of 2 theta. And we could try different substitutions, and we'll find that none of them are going to work. So what we need to do is look back at our identities and formulas to see if we have anything that's going to help us. So looking back up here, our eye might catch that we have cosine squared of x equals 1 plus cosine of 2x divided by 2. So how is that helpful? Well, let's go back down. It said that cosine squared of x equals 1 plus cosine of 2x divided by 2. So in this case, our x is 2 theta. So if we think about it that way, This says that if 2 theta is x, then we can write this as cosine of 2 theta equals 1 plus cosine of 2 times x. In this case, our x is 2 theta, divided by 2. Oops. So that tells me that cosine squared of 2 theta equals 1 plus cosine of 4 theta, all divided by 2. So let's see if that helps us with our integration. So minus the integral of 1 plus cosine of 4 theta divided by 2 times d theta. Alright, so solving this integral, we have 1/4 times the quantity theta. We can pull out this 2 on the bottom, so minus 1/2 times the integral, 1/2 integral of 1 plus cosine of 4 theta, d theta. Alright. Let's go ahead and multiply this 1/4 through. So we have 1/4 theta minus 1/8 times the integral of 1 plus cosine of 4 theta, d theta. Splitting this integral apart, we have 1/4 theta minus 1/8 times the integral of d theta plus the integral of cosine of 4 theta d theta. So we have 1/4 theta minus 1/8 times the integral of d theta. Integral of d theta is just theta. Plus, now we have the integral of cosine of 4 theta. We can finally solve this integral. We let u equal 4 theta. So du equals 4 d theta. So du divided by 4 equals d theta. So we have the integral of cosine of u times du over 4. And that integral is sine of u divided by 4. And u is 4 theta, so that is sine of 4 theta divided by 4. So plus sine of 4 theta divided by 4. Multiplying our negative 1/8 through, we have 1/4 theta minus 1/8 theta. Sine of 4 theta divided by 32, and we have to add on that c.